one of the easiest ways to describe a Cleverman would be, it's kind of like the Pope of the Dreamtime. You know, you have someone that is well respected within the clan. He is the conduit between the present and the dreaming.
It's normally a man endowed with great powers. In our world, the Cleverman has healing powers, so he can't die. When he gets injured, he heals quickly. He can foresee the future or has premonitions about what's going to unfold. And he is strongly linked to the dreaming in that spirit world.
When Uncle Jimmy passes down his Cleverman powers down to Cohen, he passes down the trait, and it's having one blue eye and one normal eye. I always thought it was the central place for the power, and Ryan just said, no, it was a sign of difference. People that usually had that, a lot of people would call them crazy and et cetera, and some people thought that they were magical. So I guess he kind of just used that as the outsider metaphor in a sense. He's different than others.
It's someone who was respected in a way as a higher being to know the difference between the dreaming and the present. And I guess the importance of that today is obviously post-colonization. That was sort of one of the first things to go. It was, you know, this power that we are giving to this man doesn't exist. And so I think that's a really big key to our storytelling in our show. It's a role that people don't really grasp because that doesn't exist today, and it's something that for Cohen, that's what he's learning to figure out. You know, there is an importance of this role, and if you can embrace it and own it, then the world's his, I guess.